Good morning, friends. Abby's here and we can get started. Mornings are so amazing. Another chance to see what God has in store for us.
Hey, Rachel, good morning.
Good morning.
You look chipper.
Well, I am pretty pumped today. I made you a big bowl of oatmeal. It's hearty and wholesome, just what we need to tackle today's word.
Well, what is today's word?
Today's word is discipleship.
What's discipleship?
Well, discipleship is exactly what Jesus asked his disciples to do just before he ascended into heaven. He said, "Go into all the world and preach the gospel." So, before we do that, you'll need this oatmeal. It's a stick-to-your-bones kind of breakfast. Oh, don't forget some fruit.
Okay. Yum.
And some milk.
Yep.
And some brown sugar.
Oh, yum.
And what do you think?
All right, let's see. Yum, wow, that is really good. Thanks, Rachel.
You're welcome.
But am I really ready to go tell others about Jesus? Don't you think you need to disciple me more first?
Oh, Abby, we'll always be learning to be better disciples. Our learning process should never stop. Remember God's grace and how you experienced God's love? And because of that, you learned compassion. You know the importance of repentance already and receiving God's forgiveness for your sins. Abby, you are definitely a worshiper and you're committed to Jesus. The Holy Spirit is living in you. You're his messenger, so I know that God is gonna use you, just like the prayer says. Use me for your glory and to invite others to follow you. So, before you finish that big bowl of yummy goodness, why don't we say the whole prayer for our friends? You have a big day ahead of you. You're really gonna be used by God today.
All right, let's say this prayer. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for loving me and making me one of your children. Help me love and obey you. Help me love others the way you love me. I'm sorry for my sins. Wash me clean. I will praise you with my whole heart. Jesus, I want to follow you as my Lord. Change me any way you want. Fill me with your Holy Spirit. I want to know your plans for me. Make me a messenger of your grace, truth, and justice. Use me for your glory and to invite others to follow you. This whole study on prayer, Rachel, has really built my faith, and I have the perfect song for you.
I can't wait.
Did you know? One of the most important people in the history of the early church was someone who actually hated Christians? It's true. His name was Saul, from a city called Tarsus. He was well known as an enemy of Christ. Christians knew to stay away from him. He got permission from the religious leaders of that time to hunt down Christians, persecute them, and imprison them. And he even thought he was doing the right thing. But all that changed one day. Saul was traveling down the road on his way to carry out his plans against the Christians, when suddenly, a very bright light from heaven caused him to go blind and fall to the ground. Then Saul heard a voice say, "Saul, Saul, why are you persecuting me?" "Who are you, Lord?" Saul asked. "I am Jesus, whom you are persecuting." Well, after hearing Jesus speak, Saul was scared and shaking. And he had to be led into the city by hand because he was blinded. And for 3 days, he would not eat or drink. At the same time, God spoke to a godly man named Ananias.
"Ananias, here I am, Lord. I want you to restore Saul's sight. I have chosen him to be a missionary."
This did not make sense to Ananias. After all, he had heard all the terrible things Saul did to Christians. But Ananias obeyed God. And he went down a particular street to a particular house and found Saul right where God said he would be.
"Brother Saul, the Lord Jesus, who appeared to you on the road by which you came, has sent me that you may regain your sight and be filled with the Holy Spirit."
Saul opened his heart to Jesus. He began preaching and teaching about Jesus everywhere he went, and many became Jesus' followers. Saul later used the name Paul, whom we know as the apostle whose teachings and letters to churches fill the New Testament and the Bible today. Paul faithfully gave God all the glory and taught others to do the same, turning the world upside down for Jesus. and his fellow disciples, so can we.
Today's memory verse is from the book of Matthew, the very first book in the New Testament, the first of four Gospels, the Good News. And you know who said it? That's right, Jesus himself. So let's repeat the words of Jesus. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Matthew 28:19. Have you ever been at a red light? Of course you have. In fact, by the time you grow up and then retire, you will have spent 3,000 hours, 122 days, which is approximately 4 months, sitting at red lights. But that's not why I brought you here today on the corner of this street. I brought you here to tell you all about green lights. Green means go. And when Jesus left the earth, he gave us all the green light to go everywhere, to everyone. These are my friends, Zach and Megan, and their family. And they got the green light to go to Thailand to tell others about Jesus. These are my friends, Christo and Sarah, and their family. They live in India, and they tell so many people about Jesus. And this is my friend, Anna, who tells children about Jesus every week from street to street to street. And this is my friend, Sophia, who shares the love of Jesus every day at school. You remember, don't you, how we learned that all of us have influence. It doesn't matter how old or how young we are, or if you live in Canada, Thailand, India, or even the United States, we can tell others about Jesus because we have the green light. So let's say it together. Memorize this one for life, friends. It will always remind you of the green light Jesus gave us. Go, therefore, and make disciples of all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Matthew 28:19. What a job we have to do now. No red lights, only green lights ahead. I gotta go. See you later.
All right, everyone. We have a job to do. Jesus asked us to go into all the world and tell others about him, to invite them to be disciples, to begin a relationship with Jesus that would grow stronger and stronger. You see this milk? This milk represents the world. It's plain. It's waiting for some color. It's waiting for the good news that needs to be shared. Food coloring is the color the world is waiting for. It's the good news of Jesus that we are called to share, that he died on the cross for us and rose again so we can have forgiveness of sins. This Q-tip is us sharing the good news, but it's hard to do on our own. You see, when we try and do it on our own and in our own power, well, kind of turns into a big cloudy mess. We need help. Who's gonna help us? That's right, we need the Holy Spirit. Let's start over, and we'll invite the Holy Spirit this time. Let's pour more milk onto a plate. The milk represents the world. It's plain, waiting for some color. It's waiting for the good news of Jesus. We need to share it, but not on our own. Remember this? Colors represent the good news we need to share to the world. This dish soap is like how the Holy Spirit helps us. Look what happens. Whoa.
Holy Spirit in us, God can work through us to color the world with good news. Wow! So we need to let the Holy Spirit guide us. We need to rely on the Holy Spirit to use us for His glory and to invite others to follow Him. How do we do that? We need to read the Bible and pray, taking time to listen for God's help and instructions. And so we know God is always with us. Who is God asking you to share the good news with?
Hi, friends. Welcome back to the Prayer Chair. The story of Paul meeting Jesus on the road to Damascus is a special story for me because I said yes to Jesus when I heard this story when I was only 5 years old. My teacher asked if anyone wanted to make the same choice Paul made to serve Jesus, and I knew I did. I knew Jesus was calling me. I've been following Jesus ever since. Do you want to say yes to Jesus too? You can. Just pray this prayer with me. Jesus, I want to follow you and learn to be your disciple, just like Paul did. Use me for your glory and to invite others to follow you. Amen. Now, all you disciples of Jesus out there, I want you to look down at your feet. Yes, you heard me. Hold them up and take a good look. Your feet are important. The Apostle Paul, the guy we just talked about, said, "How beautiful are the feet of those who bring the good news of Jesus to others." Kind of funny, eh? You'd think Paul would have talked about our mouth, the part of the body that speaks, because we're telling people about Jesus. But you know what? If our feet didn't take us to where other people were, we couldn't actually say anything to them either. We use our feet to bring us near to another person, and then, when we're face to face, in relationship with someone close enough to become friends, the message of Jesus' love for us can truly be shared. Your feet make sure you commit your whole self to the message you're giving. That message is beautiful. Therefore, so are your feet. Use your feet this week, okay? Pray for someone by name here in your prayer chair, and then get up on your feet and deliver that message of God's love to them. Then together you can grow to know more and more about God. God's love shared with others is just better. And don't forget, friends, I'm praying for you.
Friends, I've been praying for my friend Stephanie all week, and now I want to use my feet to share the good news with her. But first, I thought I'd write her a message. Can I read it to you? Okay. Dear Stephanie, I've been praying for you. God loves you so much. He sent Jesus to be your savior and friend. Can I tell you more about Jesus sometime? Love, Allie.
Hi, Allie. What are you doing?
Oh, hi, Jacob. Well, I want my friend Stephanie to know about Jesus, so I thought I'd write my thoughts in a note and then take it over to her house later tonight. Laurel encouraged me to use my feet to take myself closer to my friend, so I just thought that this might be a good way to help me get started.
I love that idea, Allie. I know I love getting a message from someone, and I love even more getting a visit from someone.
Yeah, me too. That's why I thought I'd make it all colorful with purples and pinks and reds, because she loves those colors. And it's a beautiful message of God's love, so I wanted it to look beautiful too. Friends, do you want to write out a message of God's love to your friend too? Decorate it any way you want with colors or stickers, and then ask someone to help you get it delivered. So, Jacob, would you mind driving me over to deliver it to my friend? Then my feet will take this beautiful message the rest of the way. I sure hope it'll help me have another conversation with her about Jesus.
Yeah, let's go. Bye.
Rachel, I wonder what it would have been like to be blinded like Saul was for 3 days. I mean, he knew lots about God. He knew lots about the Bible. he just didn't really have a real relationship with Jesus. And then when he was blinded by the light on the road, he fell off. His encounter with Jesus was pretty dramatic. My first encounter with Jesus wasn't that dramatic, because I could still see.
Well, Saul, now named Paul, went on to be the greatest missionary this world has ever seen.
Missionary?
Yeah, someone called by God to go into all the world and preach the gospel of Jesus.
Well then, if we love Jesus, we're all missionaries.
Exactly, Abby. You got it. That's exactly it. We're all called to make disciples. We're all missionaries. That is discipleship, inviting others to follow him. So, until next time, keep praying, because prayer not only changes things, it changes you.